guys, welcome back to the channel. Joffy Noodle Legs here today. Today we're still in the disturbing movie week, so I've got another noodle film review of a disturbing movie. Today we're in Europe, in France, and looking at Martyrs. Now, I've put this in quite a few of my top tens, mostly my sort of disturbing sort of films, because it is quite a disturbing film. Now, this is produced normal sort of disc. It's by I can't remember. I just think it's just a, it's not like Second Sight or anybody like that. It's just like a generic sort of company that have put this out. Now I'm going to try and do a review. I will put some clips in, but not too many, because it is a very sort of disturbing movie and it's not a lot of clips I can really put in it. It does deal with a harsh sort of subject matter. Mostly two major ones are child abuse and women abuse are the two major sort of factors. But then it gets to the end, the ending of the film, it sort of takes a twist and turn. So it's sort of like, look out for that at the end. I don't want to go too much into it, but the actual reason why this is happening is sort of explained at the end. Not that it's right, because it's not, it's totally wrong. But anyway, let's give you a little synopsis on the film. The film starts off with a girl sort of running through the streets in just sort of like underwear. So as you can see, she's running away from something, and it turns out that she's running away from this pediatric sort of school, because we then cut to like little scenes of like a school, like a pediatric sort of hospital sort of school, and where kids sort of live in, but they're all being abused, a lot of them. And she's obviously been abused, so she's managed to escape and run away. So yeah, we see all these little clips in the sort of title, with all the titles coming up, of these sort of like two sort of girls, and their names are Lucy and Anna. And I believe Lucy's the one that's been tortured. Anyway, so then we cut to, I think it's a conversation with the doctors or whoever it is, with Anna.
Ces messieurs sont très gentils.
D'accord.
Tu comprends pourquoi on compte Sophie? Pourquoi tu crois qu'on a besoin de toi?
Parce que vous voulez attraper les gens qui ont fait du mal à Lucie.
C'est ça, Anna.
Lucie aussi, elle dit qu'il faut les attraper.
Qu'est-ce qu'elle te dit d'autre, juste? Tu parles des heures avec elle.
Elle a peur.
Elle te raconte des choses?
Elle a peur.
Elle se souvient de quoi?
Elle sait pas qui c'est. Des fois, elle croit qu'elle se souvient, puis des fois non.
Et toi, qu'est-ce que tu crois? Tu crois qu'elle peut se souvenir?
Il faisait tout noir. Elle a pas bien vu. Elle se souvient pas.
Actually, I think it turns out that looking at the clip there, that they're actually police officers and they're trying to, I think this is like, this little bit there is post Lucy escaping. So now they're talking to Anna to try and find out, catch the people that hurt her. Which Anna doesn't really know much about, to be honest. I think because she's not been hurt by them. She's just sort of like been living at the same place. They didn't have little flashbacks, and we go back to Anna's looking for Lucy in the bedroom. So, as you can see, Lucy's very quite disturbed. She's got these marks and cuts on her arms, and I really think that Anna thinks that Lucy's doing this to herself. But anyway, we then cut to them sort of then settling down for the night. And as you can see, Lucy's very sort of disturbed. She can't sleep or restless. She hears these noises. I think it's sort of, it must be other kids being sort of abused and sort of like hit and stuff like that. It's quite horrendous. You don't see any of it at this stage, but it's quite horrendous. There's like one part of the room where it's like just a chair with chains on it, and the chair base has been cut out where a bucket's underneath if they need the toilet sort of thing. It's quite horrific. But she hears these noises, and then she sees this strange sort of creature come at the end of her bed. So, is that a strange cute creature, or is it someone that's been abused by whoever's doing this abusing? Anyway, the filming cuts forward to a few years. I think the girls are growing up. I think it's about 10 years or whatever later. And then we cut to a different house with a sort of chase going on. So you can see that wasn't really a chase. That was a brother and sister fighting over something, whatever, in the house. So we're a different family here, and they're settling down, chatting around, sort of breakfast table.
Ouais. Et alors, dis-toi, qu'elle avait un problème de pression à s'occuper.
Quand elle rigole, c'est qu'elle est vraiment pas contente.
Toi, t'es contente?
Moi? J'ai la belle vie. Chantier terminé.
Oh ben ravi.
Tiens. Cadeau du chef en prime.
Oh merde, Gabriel!
C'est dégueulasse. Dans le tuyau principal, tu crois? La voilà, ta douche qui coule pas assez fort. C'est dégueulasse.
Allez, jette-moi ça, on mange. Hein?
So they have a bit of jibber jabber going on, and they're talking about, mostly the lad talking about going to sort of like a college or school and the fees and stuff for it. So that goes on for a little bit, and then they're disrupted by someone at the door.
Je te rappelle qu'on a casqué ton bac, hein? Tes chèques tous les trimestres, pour s'entendre dire que t'en foutais pas une. Franchement, Antoine, t'es pas fatigué des fois, les petits chiants.
Je veux dire, c'est cette école, c'est pas pareil. Et après lycée, je voudrais faire quelque chose qui me plaît, moi.
T'as pas forcé quand même.
Non, mais le droit, finalement, je le sens pas.
Ah, le droit, ça mène à tout.
Ah, mais c'est pas la question. Ce qu'il veut, c'est s'installer avec sa minette.
Mais le droit, je le sens pas.
De toute façon, Antoine, si tu sentais quoi que ce soit, ça se saurait. Tu voulais arrêter le lycée pour faire pâtissier, imbécile.
Oh,
elle a
l'air rude, celle-là. C'est qui cet emmerdeur?
Revenu, Marie Belfond.
C'est dimanche quand même.
Et alors, tu te reposes de quoi le dimanche? Hein? La semaine à l'usine.
And that someone at the door, if you can see a bit of look on his face, is Lucy. and she's holding the shotgun, and she blows him, and right in the chest, and he goes flying backwards and is killed. And then she goes straight in, because the mother comes to see what's happening, and she gets shot straight away as well and killed. And then she gets the young lad on the chair and asks him how old he is, and he says, I'm 18, and she shoots and she kills him. And then she's sort of like, you can see him holding him at gunpoint.
T'as quel âge?
18.
Tu sais ce qu'ils ont fait tes parents? Hein?
So, yeah, and she asks how old he is, and she shoots him right in the chest, and he's dead. And she's just about to leave, and she hears a noise coming from the bedroom. So there she finds, she knows under the bed is someone else, so she shoots through the bed, which scares the young girl out underneath the bed, and then she gets shot as well, killed. So she's just pretty much obliterated and killed the whole family. And then she makes a phone call to Anna, who's in her car.
T'es sûre?
Je te le dis.
Lucie, ça fait 15 ans.
C'est eux.
Et tu les retrouves par hasard dans un journal.
Mais je te le dis.
Ok, on appelle les flics.
C'est pas la peine.
Quoi? J'ai fait ce qu'il fallait faire. Qu'est-ce que t'as fait?
Qu'est-ce qu'il fallait faire?
Lucie, tu devais les observer, t'étais pas sûre.
Mais je suis sûre.
Putain, je savais
qu'il fallait que je vienne avec toi. Il faut toujours que je fasse comme tu veux.
So, she tells Anna pretty much that she's sorted out the problem. Obviously Anna's a bit devastated and asks where she is, and she wants to come and join her. And then we join Lucy back at the house, and she starts hearing noises around the house. So she starts investigating these noises around the house because she believes that someone else still in there with her. But I think she thinks it's, you know, because you remember that when she was a little girl, that creature or person that attacked her, I think she believes it's her. So a little bit there. So I don't believe it's a creature. I do believe it's a woman. Jumps on her and starts attacking her with like the razor blade, slashing Lucy's back. And then Anna arrives and finds Lucy in this state and starts trying to get her out of there. And she discovers what Lucy has done. So she's trying to heal the wounds on Lucy's back, and then she tries to get rid of the bodies of the family. And as she's doing so, she sees that the mother is still awake, and she tries to help her out and get her out. But Lucy stops that from happening and then kills her with this, like a hammer over the head multiple times. It's horrible. And then it figures out that this family, that the woman, the mother, is one of the abusers of Lucy when she was younger. But Anna doesn't believe her. She thinks it's all in Lucy's imagination. And then the story sort of gets quite scary, to be honest. It's a lot around that sort of creature thing that you saw, which isn't actually a creature. It's another victim of these abusers that's been abused so bad that she's almost turned into like a monster. But it looks almost at some point it's only Lucy can see her, like it's all in Lucy's imagination. Because she starts cutting herself with like a razor blade right up here, all the way up her arm, and then up the other arm, and then Lucy slits her throat and kills herself. So this devastates Anna, because she thinks that she's going just crazy, and I think she's had not believed a lot of things that Lucy's told her, that it was all sort of like all in Lucy's head. But is it? I'm not going to tell you any more of the plot. You need to find out yourself. Or I'll tell you that from now on, the story gets into more abuse and torture. And it has a really bizarre ending, which I didn't see coming. I mean, I saw it coming because I've seen it before. But when I first saw it, I didn't see it coming. It has a bit of a crazy sort of ending to it. As I said, I'm not going to put too many clips in it because it is quite a disturbing film. There is quite a lot of violence in it, and I don't want to put stuff in it that could be offensive to people, because this does deal with child abuse. It deals with abuse of women brutally as well. Not just, you know, it's quite brutal. It's hard to watch at some point. Yeah. So, what do I think of the film? I thought the film was excellent. It's an excellent film. Really cool. Gripping film. Unusual story. I mean, first of all, it's almost a bit like sort of Hostel. You know, you feel it's going to be something like that. Then you feel, yeah, it's going to be something like Jeffrey Dahmer. It's going to be something about a girl trying to get revenge for being tortured by this killer. And it turns into something different, and it goes a different direction you don't think, and yeah, it's an excellent film. The pluses of the film, the story, although it's a little bit, it chops and changes like where it's going to go, it works, and because it's like, what's all this about, you know, and you discover what Martyrs is about. And there's some good characters in the film. Even the villains are quite good characters, apart from the guy I don't like, who's abusive to the women. Don't like him. I would love to meet him in the street if this was real, obviously. But he was obviously good because he was believable. It was horrible. I liked the way the story went. It was different. I did like the sort of the ending. Because it was strange and different, it was quite an unusual ending. So I'm not going to say anything because I don't want to ruin it. Negatives about the film. I do struggle with films that have like women abuse in it and children abuse. I mean, the child abuse you don't see too much of, you know, like the odd sort of slap and them trying to force feed the child and that when it's tied up sort of thing, but you don't see too much of that. But it's quite brutal when it comes to like the women, and I don't like that. Not sexually, by the way. It's just brute, horrible, you know, beatings and stuff I don't like. So it's difficult watch. It's very disturbing. So that is, to me, is a little negative because I don't like seeing it, but it needed in this film because it's what it's about. So I'm going to score this film as an excellent watch and give it 8 out of 10. Just solely because I can't give it any higher. There's a lot of people who love this film a lot, and it's got a real big cult following. But just because of the subject matters, I can't score them any higher than that. You know, it's just the way it is. If it's serial killers and stuff, I can live with that sort of film, you know, but when it's abuse to young people, it's like, it's difficult to swallow it sometimes. But there we go. And that's why it's a disturbing film, because of its storyline. It's not the most graphic, as a lot of them. I think Hostel and that are a lot more graphic than this. But it's really, really good film. 8 out of 10, Martyrs. Any of you seen it? If you have, let me know down below what you thought of it. Did you enjoy it? I thought it was really good. Really cool film, really good. I've seen it a couple of times now. I've not seen it for years. I bought this when it came out and I enjoyed it. And I've not watched it since. So it's probably been, oh, I don't know, maybe about between seven and 10 years as I've seen it. But I still enjoyed it. Check it out if you haven't. You might enjoy it. Really cool film. So that's day three of my disturbing movies in this movie week. So what I'm going to do now is let you know what the next one is. The next one, we're travelling again to the other side of the world, from Europe to America. And we're going to be looking at The Last House on the Left, the 1970s infamous video nasty. So that's going to be my next review and look at film tomorrow. So check out some horror channels for me, guys, if you can, please. Horror Hands, Horror Geek, Man V Film, RS Designs, Pizzawell, I Am Ice Lord, and Sarah of Horror. All really good channels. Please check them out. Till next time, look after yourselves, look after one another, and I really hope I'll see you all soon.